Today we're going to take a look at bloom effects in Photoview 360. Bloom effects are a great way to get lighting information to automatically show on your final render, and it's as simple as just adding a material that has some predefined lighting effects, or adding your own point lights as necessary. So first we're going to take a look at this render that we did previously, and we're going to add some lighting information to this. So first we'll turn on PhotoView 360 so that we can get some render options inside of SOLIDWORKS here. PhotoView 360 is part of SOLIDWORKS Professional. And then we'll add some light information based on the materials. So in SOLIDWORKS, over on the Appearances, Scenes, and Decals library, there are some materials that come predefined with light emitting information. You'll see that we have some lights here, a lights folder, and underneath that you'll see LED and neon tube and LCD, area lights, different things like that. And these are just drag and drop functionality for adding lights to materials. And you'll see that if I want to, I can add this yellow LED to these light components over here. So I'm going to just drag that to my lamp, and I'll apply that at the part level. And you'll see that those materials have now changed, and we've got some light information on those materials. Alternately, you can hold Alt while you drag this on, and you get some options for how that color looks, but also some advanced options for how the illumination effects work. So you can click on the illumination area and pick how much it's going to add for specularity and things like that, for actually adding some illumination effects there. By default, we're going to use the out-of-the-box yellow LED information. And then, in order to get true bloom effects off of those lights, we're going to go ahead and just go into our render options here, and then go into that, and you'll see bloom as a choice here. And with this bloom, we're going to turn on those options, and you have the ability to control the set point and the extent of the bloom. In this case, we're going to just bump up the bloom extent to make it a little bit larger and kind of give it a more exaggerated effect. And that's going to turn on those bloom settings when I go and do my render. So when I do my final render, you'll see that it will go through and it will render this image. And the last thing it does after it's done rendering is it will add some bloom effects, and you'll see those get calculated there. So if I zoom in a little bit on this print, you'll see that we have some new light emitting information coming in from those samples there, and that will actually add some lighting information around those LEDs. So that's how you can set some bloom effects in SOLIDWORKS. That's been my video for today. Thank you for watching.